Not the haftarah of the week, because the Ben Ishchai is not giving a lot of things. Après la haftarah de la semaine, le Ben Ishchai développe pas trop, because he give more time, more space to the haftarah of Shabbat Zachor, parce qu'il donne en fait plus de temps à la haftarah de Shabbat Zachor. So, pour les personnes qui sont en cours de conversion, qui peuvent me dire c'est quoi Shabbat Zachor? For the people who are in the conversion process, you can tell me what is, you can tell me what is Shabbat Zachor. Rabbi Ishai, c'est quoi Shabbat Zachor?
C'est parti du Shabbat spécial.
Oui.
Et la force, c'est que
c'est quoi ta réponse? Il répond à des questions.
Bien essayé.
C'est quoi ta réponse?
Ma réponse.
Oui.
C'est pour se souvenir.
De quoi?
De Amalek. Ce qu'a fait Amalek. C'est son mari.
D'accord. Ah ben, les témoins là, Cécile, vous avez une réponse?
C'est le Shabbat qui précède Pourim.
Bien fait. Et pourquoi il s'appelle Zachor?
Parce que c'est souviens-toi, je crois.
Tu te souviens de quoi?
De. Par rapport à Amalek?
Oui.
Non. Shamor Zachor.
Non, qu'on se souvienne d'Amalek. Shamor Zachor, c'est pour Shabbat. C'est pour se souvenir de la Torah et la création. Donc, le Shabbat Zachor, c'est le Shabbat qui précède toujours Pourim. Donc, quand il y a Pourim dans la semaine, le Shabbat avant, on doit lire la parashat Zachor. So, when we have Pourim in the week, the Shabbat before, we have to read the Haftarah Zachor, c'est-à-dire qu'on doit lire dans la Torah ou dans les prophètes, ça dépend qui le sait, dans la Torah, le passage où on parle de ce Zachor. C'est quoi ce Zachor? C'est ce souvenir d'Amalek. Parce qu'il y a un lien direct entre Amalek et Pourim. Why? Because there's a connection, direct connection between Amalek and Pourim. Abishai, je veux dire les quatre Shabbatot spéciaux. Oui, qui est quand?
On fait ça.
Pourquoi il s'appelle Agadol?
C'est ça, c'est Shabbat.
Non. Non.
Ah non, c'est.
Ah ouais, c'est la Réunion des Mouna. Pourquoi Shabbat Agadol avant Pessah, j'appelle Agadol?
J'ai oublié mon cours.
Le grand Shabbat de... Je sais pas.
J'ai oublié.
Ça s'appelle Shabbat Agadol. Pourquoi? Parce qu'il y a eu un grand miracle avant Pessah. Et c'est passé que les Égyptiens se sont entretués. Ils ont fait une guerre civile entre eux. Parce qu'ils ont dit, il a dit 9 makot et les 9 se sont passés. Et sa 10e makot, c'est que les premiers-nés, ils meurent. Donc, rends-lui ce qu'il veut, laisse-les partir. Et ils ont dit non. Pharaon a dit non. Donc, qu'est-ce qui s'est passé? Les aînés égyptiens se sont retournés contre leurs propres frères. Donc, ça s'appelle Agadol, parce que le miracle était grand ce jour-là. Donc, Shabbat Agadol, c'est avant Pessah. Et à quel âge Shabbat encore? Monsieur Shemouna, vous avez des idées? Which word of a Shabbat do we have? Shabbat, special Shabbat. So we have Shabbat Zachor. On a eu Shabbat Zachor. On a vu, c'est Amalek. Ensuite, on a dit Shabbat Agadol. Ici, Shabbat Agadol. before Pessah. Et on a vu pourquoi. Et encore, quel autre Shabbat? Which other Shabbat, which other Shabbat do we have? After Shabbat Zachor, c'est quoi? Après Shabbat Zachor, c'est quoi? Je vais recommencer. Avant Shabbat Zachor, on a fait quel Shabbat? Spécial. Before Shabbat Zachor, which Shabbat special did we do? Shkalim. Shabbat Shkalim. What did we do in Shkalim? About what? Machatit HaShekel. On a lu le Machatit HaShekel. Après Shabbat Zachor, Rabbi Shai.
Rabbi Shai.
Après Shabbat Zachor. Rabbi Shai, on est sur tes comptes aujourd'hui. Tu nous as manqué. On va te faire transférer aujourd'hui. Après Shabbat Zachor. Après, oui. Ah ouais, c'est Félix Mouna. On va le laisser. Lui, il est là-bas. Il est chaud. Il a voulu faire le coup. Il voulait être dans la salle. Donne les réponses maintenant. Ok. Après Shabbat Zachor. Après Shabbat Zachor. Shabbat. Para. C'est quoi Shabbat Para? Il a fait. On parle de la Para Adouma. Après Shabbat Para. Abishai. Ah ouais, je savais que t'avais faux, mais on t'écoute.
Non, Shabbat Para.
Après Shabbat Para, c'est quoi? Ah ben
Kadosh.
Shabbat
à Kadosh.
Shabbat à Kadosh.
Oui.
Non, il n'y a pas. Il n'y a pas. Abisha, tu n'as pas d'idée? C'est quoi le jeu de mots? Fais ton jeu de mots.
Shabbat
à Tzvi. Shabbat à Tzvi.
Il n'y a pas un Shabbat avant Yom Tov.
Mais quel Shabbat?
Je mon cours à Dieu.
Avant qu'il pose, c'est quel Shabbat?
Chozer, c'est quoi? The famous. Non, non.
Toda, Shabbat Tshuva. Shabbat Teshuva, le Shabbat de la Teshuva. Là, c'est Shabbat. Donc, on a c'est Amalek. Il a beaucoup plus que ce que tu as dit. Donc, on a dit quoi? Shkalim, Zachor, Para. Shabbat Agadol. T'as oublié avant Pessah. Shabbat Agadol. Et c'est avant Pessah. Before Pessah. And the other one. Before Kippour. Shabbat Tshuva. Avant Kippour. There was another one, but this I won't believe to be hard with you. Il y a encore un autre. There was another one. I will help because I know you will not find. No. Shabbat Mevachim. Before Rosh Chodesh. Shabbat for Rosh Chodesh, Shabbat Mevachim. So all the people who are in conversion, you have to know all this by heart because it will be asked to you. Tous ceux qui sont en conversion, je vous dis ça par cœur, ça sera demandé dans les questions. What are the special Shabbatot? Shkalim, Zachor, Para. Non, sorry. Shkalim, Zachor, I'll read two times. Shkalim, Zachor, Para, Agadol, Tshuva, Mevachim. So let's see now what Rabbi Nishchai said about Shabbat Zachor on Amalek. Or ce que Rabbi Nishchai dit dans le Shabbat Zachor par rapport à Amalek. Il dit là qu'on est dans le Sefer Shmuel Aleph. Chapter 50. Je ne sais pas ce que c'est. Rabbi Nishchai, tu peux m'aider pour la lecture en anglais? On va te faire bosser. Il y a des vacances là. On voit ta tête à dormir toute la journée.
Le...
Yesterday was the only test for them. Today you're gonna sweat. I'm on you. I'm on your shoulder. Ah ouais, tu donnes un cours invisible. C'était filmé?
Oui. J'ai là mais.
Faut envoyer la vidéo. On va contrôler le cours.
Je lis juste.
So let's go Shmuel Aleph.
Rabbi, s'il vous plaît, vous pourrez prendre en photo pour le mettre sur le groupe.
Oui, oui.
Merci, Rabbi.
Et tout de suite. Sorry. Chapitre 15, chapitre 15. Shalom Rabbi Elazar.
Shalom, shalom, Rabbi.
Shalom, shalom, Rabbi Tel Sheva. Rabbi Elazar, he keep quiet. He said, it's a question moment. I will say errors.
Shalom, shalom, Rabbi.
Shalom, shalom.
4 o'clock in the morning, you know.
Yeah, 4 o'clock. You say what? I want just to listen. I want to talk. So, without a shame.
15.
The Shmuel Aleph, first book of Shmuel, chapter 15, from the first pasuk. So, essaie de lire fort pour qu'ils t'entendent avec le micro. Shmuel dit un jour à Shaoul. C'est moi. Partager. Tu as la photo qu'il a mis dans le groupe, tu peux l'envoyer dans les autres groupes, s'il te plaît, la pêche. C'est-à-dire, Shmuel dit à Shaoul. Donc, Shmuel dit à Shaoul. C'est moi que Hachem avait envoyé pour te sacrer roi de son peuple, Israël. Maintenant donc, obéis aux paroles d'Hachem.
Shmuel said to Shaul, Hachem sent me to anoint you as king over his people, over his Israel. So now hear the sound of Hashem's words.
Next pasuk, dit comme ça. Dit, ainsi parle Hachem Tevaot. J'ai à demander compte de ce qu'Amalek a fait à Israël en se mettant sur son chemin quand il sortait d'Égypte.
So said Hashem Tzivaot, I have remembered what Amalek did to Israel, the ambush he placed against him on the way as he went up from Egypt.
Maintenant, va frapper Amalek. Et anéantissez tout ce qui est à lui, qu'il n'obtienne point de merci. Fais tout périr, hommes et femmes, enfants et nourrissons, bœufs et brebis, chameau et âne.
Now go and strike down Amalek and destroy everything he has. Have no pity on him. Kill men and women alike, infant and suckling alike, ox and sheep alike, camel and donkey alike.
So I said, it's very serious. Très sérieux. You have the order from Hashem to kill women, kids, and little babies. Yes, kids. Give to Rabbi Benjamin the chumash. The Tanna. What does it mean to Rabbi Benjamin? Can you read for me? Yeah, read everything.
Kill. Kill man and woman alike.
Yeah.
Infant and suckling alike, mm-hmm. Ox and sheep alike, camel and donkey alike.
You see? Mm-hmm. Did you know that Hashem asked us to kill women and kids of Amalek? You knew it?
No.
Ah, so the question is why? We have to understand what's happening. Like this, Pakadati. Let's try to understand what does it mean. The second pasuk, Pakati et Asher Asa Amalek l'Israël Asher Sham lo baderer ba'aloto mimitzrayim. Say, I remember what Amalek did to Israel when they basically blocked us when we went out from Egypt.
Yeah,
you remember? It's because of that he will decide to take revenge on them. Hashem se souvient de ce qu'Amalek nous a fait en sortant d'Égypte. C'est ça qu'il va décider. De se venger, de prendre revanche sur eux. So, let's see what's in the Ben Yishraï. Ben Yishraï dit, Yesh le'avim, we have to understand, on doit comprendre. Omer, Asher, Sham, Lo, Baderer. So the expression to say, because I remember what Amalek did to Israel when they went out from Egypt, the expression is, Asher, Sham, Lo, Baderer. L'expression pour dire que je veux me souvenir de ce qu'Amalek a fait au Bnei Israël, dans le texte du Nar, il dit Asher Shamlo Derer. Donc il dit Le Korah Meshula'al Avana. So c'est, we have to understand because the sentence, the pasuk is not so clear. It's translated like that, but it's not exactly what he said. He said, Amalek l'Israël, Asher, Sham, Lo, Baderer, La, Aloto, Bimitzraim. It's not exactly the translation that because we make ambush or they block us. It's not, it's said like that. C'est pas vraiment dit comme ça. Il dit, c'est parce qu'en fait, il y avait quelque chose qui était lié là-bas, Baderer, quand on est sorti d'Égypte, qui a poussé Amalek à agir d'une certaine manière. Et Hashem, il veut pas pardonner ça. Pourquoi? On va voir. C'est. Venira les Farej, Bisset Adishmaïa, here is the way we can explain Bezat Hashem. Voici ce qu'on peut dire Bezat Hashem. Ki Yadoua, Masha Amour, Abotem Zichron Livracha, Bamidrash Shmuel, Tanchuma, Asher Karecha Baderer. So c'est basically in the Midrash, they explain differently. Dans le Midrash, they speak différemment. They explain something that we know, but we never know where it comes from. We say, no, Amalek made us cold in the way. Cold about doing Torah, cold about arriving in Israel, cold about being happy of what we are living. Donc, en fait, il y a une expression qu'on emploie souvent par rapport à Amalek. On dit qu'il nous a refroidi en sortant d'Égypte. On avait une froideur comme ça, peu d'enthousiasme. Donc, il dit, de Midrash Tanhuma, il dit en fait que Asher Sham Loba Derer, c'est pour dire que it's to talk about the coldness of the situation of our heart at that moment. Il dit Asher Sham Loba Derer, c'est pour parler de la froideur qu'on avait presque en sortant alors qu'on venait de vivre un des miracles les plus probants de l'histoire. How can you be cold when you are just rent food, one of the biggest miracles ever? Never Hashem was revealed himself in that way in the history. Never. Even after We don't have some here and there situation, but at that way, on such a long period with makot, 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 up in the sea, you go through and you get cold. Comment tu peux devenir froid après tous ces événements-là que tu vis? Donc il dit, Rabbi Yehuda Omer, Rabbi Yehuda Omer, Timacha, Kamaada, Kamade At Amar, Kiye Becha, Ish Asher Loye, Taor, Mikere Laila. Écoulé. Donc il dit, Rabbi Yehuda, il dit, la notion de froideur, c'est parce qu'en fait, c'est comme si on t'avait mis une touma. Une touma qui a fait que tu n'étais plus tahor. Et c'est Rabbi Yehuda said, that aspect of being, that coldness, it's kind of you receive a kind of impurity on you. And that impurity made what you were no more pure. Impurity. C'est une impureté en fait qui rend les gens froids. It means that if you are cold about the situation, basically, it doesn't mean that you are a strong man or a strong woman. It means that you are surrounded by a kind of tuma, impurity. To be insensitive to people's situations, to be insensitive to what's happening in the world, to be sensitive to things, it doesn't show that you're a tzaddik. Not being emotional doesn't mean to be insensitive. It's two different things. You have to be sensitive. You have to consider people's situation, what they face, what they go through. Always ask if they are really built to face what they are facing. Consider that thing. Donc, il dit quoi ici de faire attention? Il dit qu'il y a une grande différence entre l'émotion et la sensibilité. Il dit la froideur dont on parle ici, où on dit que les gens sont devenus insensibles parce qu'ils étaient impurs, c'est une insensibilité chronique. C'est-à-dire que tu n'as même pas la décence de considérer ce que ton prochain peut traverser. Donc, il ne faut pas confondre la sensibilité avec l'émotion. On ne parle pas d'être émotionnel. On parle en fait de savoir être sensible à ce que l'autre vit. And he said, if you are insensitive, it's impurity. C'est ça. That's it, mine. I said, I know that you need it. I said, don't care, give it to me. My man, give it to me. Insensitive. You have to be sensitive to people's situation, to consider what they are facing before to do anything. This is the secret of wisdom. Il faut être sensible à chaque situation. Savoir ce que les gens traversent, c'est le secret de la sagesse. Pourquoi? Parce que David Amir était connu pour être très sensible à ce que chaque juif pouvait traverser dans son royaume.
In a personal situation or in any situation, if someone like continually wrongs you, the natural response to that is to become callous or indifferent. How do we stay engaged and sensitive to their plight, but protect ourselves in a situation? I mean, we're all going to face this outside pressure, and there's going to be people that we're like, we can still love them on a certain level, but like, we don't need to be in their company because they're not good for us.
I agree with you. I understand your question, but it's two different things.
Okay.
Being sensitive is not about warning also. Because the very healthy sensitivity comes from the corner of what people tell you. Not from the corner of what you build by yourself. You try to interpret the situation, say, you need that. No, they don't ask you for that. I'm telling you something in order to inform you about my situation. And this gives to you the right, the possibility to accomplish one mitzvah, to be sensitive to my situation. But if you come to warn me, it's not sensitivity, it's kind of authority on people. Donc en fait, c'est différent. Chia, il a demandé une chose, il a dit, mais comment on fait avec les gens qui, pour des raisons de sensibilité, ils viennent et t'avertissent, ils disent, fais pas ça. Comment on se protège d'eux et ne pas s'abîmer? Il fait, non. Il y a encore une grande différence entre le fait d'être sensible à quelque chose et le fait d'avertir quelqu'un. L'avertissement, en général, on le fait sans forcément considérer la sensibilité de l'autre, la sensibilité de la situation. La sensibilité dont je parle ici, c'est la personne est informe de sa situation et toi, maintenant, tu la prends en considération et tu deviens sensible à ce qu'il affronte. So it's different. It's really you give me the information first, and because you gave it to me, it gives to me the right to do that. Means about to be sensitive to your situation. But even if I see that this is maybe situation, I will never act before receiving the issue from you. To remark that people are missing things doesn't mean that you have the right to go to say, okay, here is what you need. No, I didn't ask you. Je t'ai pas demandé. You are not sensitive. You are passing the borders of my private life.
Sorry.
Yeah.
The situation that I'm thinking of that fits maybe is like Sarah and Ishmael.
Yeah.
She saw that this situation wasn't good. From the outside, it looks like her actions were very insensitive.
Mm.
And maybe even Abraham felt that. And so he prayed for Ishmael. Was Sarah completely good in what she and how she handled that?
Yes,
it's just like this is
yes.
bad for what
no,
my
she
son
was,
and it's not.
She was right, because when the son is not bar mitzvah, you have on you the obligation to be sensitive to his mentally, psychologic, kedushat.
So it's a battle of
yeah, she it's her.
Okay.
Because all the way from zero to let's say bar mitzvah, it's on the shoulder of Sarah. It's not on Avram's shoulders. So she have to care, take care about that education. So she has to be sensitive to what he's facing.
So after your child's bar mitzvah, you have to be sensitive. Before
you have to be sensitive for your kids from zero to bar mitzvah. When you come bar mitzvah, you have to let him give you to you the space.
Yeah, exactly.
To apply
enter,
this
to
sensitivity.
Enter, to enter. And with a wife, you have to get permission to enter, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Whereas the Pirkei Avot said that don't talk too much to your wife. So we understand that there's some things you didn't tell her at all.
Mm.
So there's some situation you keep for you.
Mm.
So if she says you're not eating, she has to understand that I will be allowed to enter in that area when you will express something. But to start say, oh, you don't eat, something wrong. Oh, you made me crazy. I did something wrong. If I give to you information.
Where's the belt?
If I give to you that information, yes, it's give to you the mitzvah, possibility to do the mitzvah, to enter in my private sphere. And it's very important because sometimes because we are a couple, we think that that border is removed. No, it's not removed. Because the Pirkei Avot say, don't talk too much. So if you don't talk too much, there's information that you will keep and you will give it maybe afterwards. But it's very important, very thin. And he said, this is the problem of Amalek. It becomes insensitive to things. Il dit, le problème d'Amalek, c'est ça. C'est qu'en fait, on devient insensible et qu'il faut savoir bien mettre la distinction entre ce que on dit aux autres qui leur donne un peu la possibilité de faire la mitzvah, d'être sensible à ce que nous traversons, et ce qu'on ne leur dit pas et qu'eux, ils forcent. Et ils rentrent dans notre vie sans qu'on leur ait demandé. Et c'est des fois même contre-productif. And sometimes make the opposite. If you notice that someone needs something, but he doesn't tell you anything, and you enter, and you start to question, it can be, it even create the opposite. Ça peut même créer l'opposé. So just 1 second.
The Balakhan, you said don't give free things.
Give 1 second, just get the kids.
Without He's thinking about somebody else, like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
can I tell you why you got married?
Yeah. Sorry, I think this is the character of like, I don't really care what you want, I want to.
You would have this. I have to tell you the truth to people.
Oh, wait, of course. But it turns into like, I'm in your business way really more than I need to be.
Wow.
Their parents are like that.
That's cool.
But a lot of times it comes for getting in a place where they don't
know. Parents
giving space. I wouldn't know. My parents gave me tons of space.
Especially Congolese parents.
Yeah, cultures don't.
They don't care.
Understand that.
Je suis bar mitzvah. Et alors, je rentre quand même.
They don't understand.
You bar mitzvah, like, and so.
But you said that then
came in the room.
Unnecessarily caused friction between them and their son. Unnecessarily.
Oh, okay.
Now a young adult, it's a different relationship. From 0 to 13, he was your slave.
It's from the Torah. It's the veil that Moshe had in front of his face.
If you don't tell me, I don't care.
Yeah.
It just
came.
Sure.
Whoa.
What he said. So basically, becoming insensitive to people's situation, this is what is called the impurity of Amalek. Devenir insensible au problème des situations des gens, c'est ce qu'on appelle la Touma d'Amalek. So, see what's happening, what's his pass? Ya'an Sham, v'nimtza, darshu karecha lashon keri. Yadua, ki Touma zo I ba'a, ונעשית על ידי הקליפת נוקבה, הקליפה, נוקבה דקליפה. גם ידוע מה שכתוב בספר מאורי אור, כי נוקבה ופלוני נקראת עלה. ומצידה כל העלות. כל העלות, יען שם. וזהו שהמאר פקדתי את אשר עשה עמלק לישראל, אשר שם לו גמטריה אלה. היא נוגבה דפלוני, דהתבקעה בדרך של האב, לטעמה בה. ובכתוב אשר קרחה בדרך. So, here's the way we understand. Voici la manière dont on comprend. Il dit que ce qui s'est passé, what's happened? That coldness is called karacha. He made you cold. He brought you to be very, a lot of coldness. Il t'a rendu très, 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 très froid. Donc il dit, cette froideur, karacha, karecha badere, il sait. Ça vient du nom d'une autre situation. It comes from a name of another situation. Kerry. What is Kerry? Ça vient d'une autre situation, c'est ce qu'on appelle Kerry. C'est quoi Kerry? C'est Zera Levatala, perdre du Zera, double exit.
That's Pinchas.
Yes.
I have a question, because I see in the name Kerry, when you switch the word again, when you switch it back, your yod, kuf, like resh, it's like yekar. What does that mean, yekar?
Yekar, you will be called.
You called, huh?
You would be cold.
No, I think it's like complete yakar. It's like beautiful or something, or
yeah, yakar.
It's a Latin
word. Or maybe expensive.
Yeah.
Very expensive. Or you can do yerek, vegetables, but after it's you to bring the suya. Donc il dit, ce karacha, il t'a fait froid, il t'a rendu froid dans le chemin. It makes you very to have a high level of coldness in your heart. It's because they lost carry. Ils ont perdu du zera. So what happened? People, they go out from Mitzrayim. You see all the many things. What happened? You masturbate or you lose seeds. What is that? How do you lose seeds? It's my question. How do they lose seeds? They went out from Egypt. They work what? One day. Maybe people say no. Maybe because when you are very happy of the victory, you know it's known after the big victory of a football match, war, what's happening, people make babies. Oh, maybe. But I want to understand. How come? You see all the miracles. You have all the miracles. What you perds? What you have perds? It's perdu zera. No, it's something else. It's no, it's scary. To give what you give to the planet. You're telling.
Don't say anything. Rabbi. Lower the TV a bit. Somewhere here.
When people see when they're just bored. A lot of times you can eat just because they're bored. They have nothing to start to think. And so maybe when they went out from time, it was the first time in 210 years where they just had nothing. They just had free time. And free time caused them to spend thoughts on that.
Let's say you have nothing to do. You live in a modern society where apartment clothes, no one sees you. You are in the desert. Everybody is like, okay, you have tents, but it's holiness. You have a, it's not like you don't have motion generation. You know the guy, it's serious. You come in with in your forehead, you know what's happened. It's not like you are, okay, go live in your apartment, no one sees you. You can be seen at every time. The time you have Moshe, you have Hu, you have Miriam, you have Aaron, you have Shuri Shaddai, Shaddai, you have other people. How can you? You feel right. Like trap. You cannot.
Rabbi Pinchas.
Can you say that the Arab Rav were not really Balaam for the Torah at that time? Not necessarily the Torah. You know, the Torah with them. Attached to Klal Yisrael. That Hashem told them that it's too soon. Like, they wouldn't do what you're going to do. What he wanted to do. So you have their Balaam that
I agree with you, with your first level of argument, but I have a problem. The text is said, Asher asa maik le Yisrael. Not tzin le am haaretz.
Rav Pinchas.
Yeah.
One thing I drash from this is that just like Kerry, mean cold. So when you become cold, You know, because the yisod is always like, you know, I don't want to say cold, like, you know, cold, like in terms of gevura, then it makes you do zigalivatala. So when you switch the word around, which is yekar, which is expensive. So it tells you when you do descend, it's a very expensive, it costs you expensively. It's a very costly sin because you have to do sheleg to, you know, 5 times for 3 days. You see what I mean? So yes, you do it, there's carry, you go that path, but then that same carry is here to remind you that it's also very expensive when you do such a sin.
Belle chassidut, j'avoue, bravo. C'est très bien, très bien. C'est... On peut rien dire, c'est bien. C'est vrai ce qu'il dit. Un bisou. Il faut que tu... On va ouvrir un betrabat pour toi.
Hein?
Ah, this... What Abisha said, we may think that it's only Revra, but it's not Ibn Israel. On penserait peut-être que le Revra est Ibn Israel.
Well, let's have them in the Bechina of not being Ruhi in some aspect of receiving the Torah, because we the Rishash tells us we're dealing with Binyane Ruhi.
Yes.
So we're not dealing with physical feet.
Yes.
So how do we understand this in Ruhi? So then, on a certain level, by Israel, were not ru'ui to receive even the Torah that Moshe gave them in a certain aspect. And so the cup, something spilled out. Like we know that the Ari says, even when everything's done right, if the drop that falls after, the drop that falls before, it's to the queen of Zerlovatala.
I agree with you. So what? Look what he said.
Oh, that's the shattering of the Ukol Rishono. It's like drops that fell before the Zibu. Because Moshe came down the mountain, he gave, right? When he gave them the second Luchot, that was the Zibu. But the shattering of the Luchot Rishono is the Bechina of Zer Lepadala. He went up to Das Elyon, got the Zera, brought it down, and then realized, oh wow, that Klal Yisrael's not ready for this, and threw him on the ground, and they shattered, and that was like Bechina of Zera.
Yes.
Being thrown on the ground.
I agree with you.
And that was, I mean, that was, and that, and Yisrael was included in that too, because we don't have, we didn't get the Torah at all.
So what he said basically, qu'est-ce qu'il dit en résumé? Assis-toi. Qu'est-ce qu'il dit? He said that the losing seeds, this is what brings you to being sensitive to people. So I give you one key, don't need clay. If you see people being sensitive to people's situation, wow. Why that coldness? Pourquoi cette froideur? Mais je sais, de ça je tell you. Je me dis, c'est le coup, Rabbi Yehuda. C'est un zéro levatala. That's why it's cold. C'est ça qu'il est cold.
So when he is insensitive.
Yeah. Il est insensible. Why? It's because at that moment, the clipper will take your seeds and make you very full of coldness, is called Allah.
No. Okay, makes sense.
Are you see now? It's really Allah. What is strange, just here bizarre, is that in Allah, hey, I can make a wonderful douche if I want to do some chassidut. When I was doing hell, I had the last hit. Go!
It was also Ele.
Ele!
These are your.
Yes! On pourrait faire un gros rush. He said, no. He said, because that klipa, that comb, it's called Allah. And he said, from her come called the Allahot.
What's Allahot?
Is the prayer of Allah?
Really? What? Ben Shkai is saying, from Akari Zerbatala, from us being cold, we create alone.
Yeah. Look what is he asking you. Study. C'est, il dit comme ça. Il dit, she nukva de Ploni. She is the wife of sa mère même. C'est la femme de sa mère même. She it bika bederer. Elle s'est collée sur le chemin. La derer is the yesod. C'est le yesod. Et tamaba, to make the derer tamé, pour faire le yesod tamé. Bekatou, asher karacha bederer. Et la chen amar. Pakati, betam, zakav gadol. One more time. He said, look in the text. Regardez le texte. Ici. Ça suffit des bonbons, Didi. C'est bon? What did he say? Pakati. So you see here? Pakati. He said, this is the term called Zakav Gadol. He said, this is to tell us all the story he just explained. He said, Zakav Gadol is here to talk about the story he just explained. Comment? He said, regarde. Akati betaam Zakav Gadol. Shem Misparo, Keminyan, Shem Avaya. He said, quand tu prends le Zakav Gadol, qui est comme ça, ça fait Gematria 26. Meaning, Shem Avaya. 10, 10, and 6. 26. Et ça suffit. 10, 10, et 6, ça fait 26. Donc, il dit quoi? Il dit, Shem Avaya, les orot qui a nekeva a nekama tichuya v'amalek mitzad qui בסיבתו אין השם שלם, כמו שנאמר, כי יד על כסייה, מלחמת השם לבי המלאק. זה basically, because he did that by getting, bringing us to make that scene, just straight after we went out from Egypt, because of that, the name of Hashem is not full, it's missing. Like we said, the yad is on the case. La main de Malek est sur le kissé. He said, that's why the revenge of Hashem is like really intense, because his name is damaged because of that situation. Son nom est endommagé dans la situation. So it comes to the point that Rabbi Shaul, meaning that we're talking about mochin, sin, some light which have been expressed, and straight someone bring and broke it or brought kind of tuma. Donc on parle d'une lumière qui est exprimée avec la libération d'Égypte, mais quelqu'un est venu et a apporté une touma dedans. Après, il dit, « Veine, nirali, jadishmaya od ki mispar ala, sheu beklipat de nukva de ploni, im » So he said basically, sorry, I forgot to say that, il a dit comme ça, l'expression « asher sham lo ». You see, il s'est « lo, la medvav is gematria ala ». That's why the way to express Asher Sham Lo is the Western way to talk about making us cold with boldness. He said, Lo, Lamed Vav, Sigematria, Lamed Aleph, He. Donc, Lo, il est là pour parler de cette dimension de Allah. Donc, il dit, le mot Allah, c'est quoi? What is the word Allah also? Et nous va des ploni. Et mis par derrière. Si maintenant je fais Allah, meaning 36. Plus derrière, Gematria, ça. D'ici, je prends maintenant Allah, et je rajoute derrière. Et ça fait ça, Mishpar, ça. Chez où, Mishpar, Rakil. Qui est aussi la gématria du mot rakil. Qui colle kavanato basé à Touma qui est déchiré à Sar chez le haut, rakil le davar qui categoria Yad Israel. That is Rakil, meaning that c'est comme si il va se charger personnellement de ça. C'est-à-dire le but d'amener les personnes à faire cette faute-là, c'est comme si on voulait que sa mère même, lui-même, vienne en considération pour bloquer Israël dans son évolution. Pas un autre ça, sa mère même lui-même. Rakil in English.
Rakil ou Rakil?
C'est la même chose.
C'est quelqu'un qui lui possède. Ouais, quelqu'un qui veut prendre quelque chose et voir.
C'est par du Lachonara, c'est une question catégorique. To be this one who's going to make the accusation, but not another one. Him himself. The Tsar shall Samer, shall Amalek. Like him. Après, il dit, Yassar, Shelo, Rakil, et d'abord, Gamze, ou Nispar, Horban. C'est le Ma'a, Kamanato, Bazé, qui dit, la Sot, Horban, la Migdash Israël. Tu sais, this word, Rakil, it also the same Gematria of Horban, destruction. C'est ça, Gematria de Horban. Dit, ce mot-là, Allah, si je le colle derrière, meaning if I connect Allah to derrière, if I bring this impurity under Yesod, I create Tsar. That Tsar is basically the root of all the accusations against us. And this will build the destructions of our temples, inner and externals. Donc il dit, tout ça commence par la connexion du Allah et du derrière. Always start with that. That will give to you something. It is not said here, but the point finished. This is also why you see that Rabbi Akiva ben Yosef is important. C'est là aussi où vous pouvez Rabbi Akiva et Yosef, il est important. Because Rabbi Akiva will bring, is the master of the Netzé Torah Shibalpe. C'est le maître de la Torah orale. Right? Is the master, okay? Why is it connected? Who is the grandfather of Rabbi Akiva?
Himself.
Yes, with the closer.
Sisra.
Akadosh is talking about this in the Shah Gigolim. He said, who is Sisra? He explained why Rabbi Akiva to come from Sisra, and he talked about the secret of the Tsar. Samer Resh. What does it mean? Why you see these two letters in Rabbi Akiva's ascendant? Go there and you will understand what, why Amalek and the Girim, we have beef. Allez voir ça parce que si vous avez ça sur Gilgulim, pourquoi il y a Sisra et Sisra, c'est notre descendant de Rabbi Akiva, et pourquoi il y a toujours une tension entre les Amalécites et les Guéris. Et on finit. Mais il est. Vas-y, Van Gam, Ken, Remez, Akatou, Vemer, Agag, Ke, Echan, Sar, Mar, Mavet, Otelomar, Otomis, Par, Sar. C'est le cas de word of. Agag also, he used also in his expression the pasuk sar. Agag also uses the sar, meaning that is the way for them to be empowered. How connect Allah with the derer? That's why I said Rabbi Shai yesterday. There is nothing worse when someone is ordained by Allah is saying that you are not so holy. You are a Jew, but you are not bringing holiness in your behavior, your soul, and so on. Great that. Shechatab o Amalek. She'idbik haklipa nikra alad. So use klipa. Now it's written. It's écrit noir sur blanc. There's a klipa. And he cried, Allah.
Rafin Kaz, is that the same Allah we know today? If you want to put it this way?
I don't know. I'm just reading my text.
No, it's written almost the same way, though. It's written literally almost the same way.
Yes. But it's what we sang for 10 minutes. Yes. This is exactly that. Après, il dit, mais derrière, les Tamé et Israël, Niarmazlo, Ata'a, Mar, Amavet, this is what brings even the bitterness of death. C'est ce qui amène l'amertume de la mort. Qui va avouer Stavu Benekama Binkom Beamalek. So say what the purpose of all the speech of Hashem is to let us understand that it's a purpose, it's forever that revenge that we have to take over Amalek. C'est pour toujours cette revanche-là qu'on doit prendre sur Amalek. So meaning that when you are a victim of your losing seeds, you are basically under the influence of Amalek. This is Amalek. It's Amalek. People say, Amalek, it's Iran. Amalek, it's Putin. Putin, he never came in your dreams. So, Amalek is you. It's what brings you to lose seeds.
That's why the first...
In the
Zohar, they speak about the five Amalekim, but the Amalekim specifically, those are the ones who love women, Jewish women. So there is it's linked with the, like you say, with the fact that because people who see it, Shalom, both men and women, and also why is Purim so important, because in Purim that out the Yesod of Abba, which is the Megillah. So basically, by doing that, we are inferring that no, this is where we are resisting. What comes out would be Mordechai and not Aman, which is Zerali Batala, but Mordechai is the one who will.
Exactly. So, what is the war of Amalek?
The war of the Essen.
Purim!
I think we can still call Germania Amalek because the modern education system is Prussian.
Yeah.
And they teach to waste.
Yeah.
So.
Yes. All Europe.
Yeah, but specifically German.
We can of course identify some people, on peut identifier certains peuples being the physical expression of Amalek. But what is Amalek? So when you fast, made 3 days, like what they were doing, you're fighting seriously. You're removing that coldness. Because what is the biggest expression of coldness? It's when I sense without considering Hashem's sensitivity. Not sensitive to Hashem situation. C'est quoi la dimension la plus extrême de la dimension Amalek? C'est quand je faute volontairement en ne m'étant même pas sensible à la position d'Hashem à ce qu'il me dit.
So what was the courage that the actual
Egypt? What?
What was the wasting of what was the zerbatana?
You have to find it. I just brought the question. So you have to complete the limit. It makes sense that the Jewish people have to fight them. Is that out of Yisrael? It's the place where it's supposed to stand all the tuma of the Piriya. And when Moshe is holding hands, why Chur here, Aaron here? Not a shame. Baruch Adonai Leolam Amen
v'Amen.
V'Amen.
Garen. People that have a brit milah later in life, there's no way to do Piriya. How can we understand that person's relationship to Yishmael? Because Yishmael is connected to Piriya. Meaning, you see a lot of Garen, they're like on fire against Christianity. Because that makes sense. They have an orla, they take the orla or whatever. But there's no physical peeling back of this membrane because at an older age, it's just not there. So is there a way to understand this relationship?
Yes, yes. This is the machloket in the Gemara between Rabbi Shimon and the sage. The sage said, we cannot trust them.
Because of this.
Yes, this is really what I mean. Because there's no piriya. If there's no piriya, the yud is not kivil.
So it's, their monotheism could be like
it's all Islam, a shed. It's still a shed, yes. So now what's the Rabbi Shimon? Say, yes, you're right, except if he goes to the tikkunim. So what you do in the tikkunim, basically, you rebuild the dimension of yud of Shaddai. That's why Gerim, who just fight back the idea of son, behind shed. So the shed will for sure will fight what will remove him from a place. So that's why in the Minag Afrika, what we say, you do your 3 day shed like before you come in like this, the shed goes also. Because like you said, many people they went to the mikveh, they are just shed, the shed again get me, but yes, it's not that so it's not written for me to shed. Many people go, shed mikveh. Donc en fait, c'est ça, c'est juste ça. This is really the machloket. The sage said, look, the piriya have been swallowed in the skin. Mm-hmm. They become one. So we didn't rebuild the yod. So it's still a shed. So what do we do? Even if, let's say, in Africa, we do it very hard, let's say 1 month, 3 months. But after 1 month, you see the very thin skin. It's already connected. So what you have to do? It's a shelag. If you don't, si tu fais pas trop your shelag, there is no way you can prove that you remove that. But also, you see many game, they convert, was sincere, but they have a lot of problems with the botina, a lot. What problem? Losing seeds, or masturbation, or women's. This shows to you that every time you didn't go to through the process of shilling, it's not enough. So here's the next question. So you have still gerim after one shilling or two, but still lose teeth. I say yes, because you need to be actually 5 shilling.
And also you need to do the food with that. So you always restarting.
5 times you have to do the shilling.
Because if I remember correctly, the shilling is not enough.
Yeah,
you
yeah,
have to not do that sin for 40 days.
You have to have good midot for 40 okay, days. It's not a so it's a ta'aseh.
Okay, so ta'ase. You have to do have good will for it. So you have to do that 5 times.
So you have 5
fingers. 5 times. No, you try to give you strength.
Yeah,
it's
fine. It's a good number.
You're stable with
five.
If you
fail
on your
40
days, but on
needed,
so it's
not
counting.
No, not counting. Every time you don't did 5, you're still
So it's one for each of them, I suppose.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You can use
okay, it. So it's before Pesach.
I need 5 or 10 of you. Last night, you spoke about Allah.
I'll even show you something because you're exciting me. Leave me alone, no. I want to be calm today. That's my book.
You see one like this?
Yeah. Oh, Alivana. See, Michelle said basically, if you do 5 times shelag, you do, is connected to the Mansapar, yes? Why? Because you know what we say at the end of Purim, right? What do we say? You call it Fund Purim. I found the lecture of the Megillah. De même en Matsapa. Arrête, Rivenu. Arrête. After Adan et Dinenu made our justice. This is the noon of Matsapa. You made Nokem et Nikmatenu. Amalek. This is the tzadi of Matsapa. After you say Anifra Lanu Umi Tsarenu. This is the pay. Refer à. This is the chaf. And what we have at the end, we know that Pinchas is in the sod, right? Like you said, we see it in the kafot of Sifat Torah. So you said, Baruch Mordechai, Aru Aman, and so on. So you say, Aru Aman, Baruch Mordechai, Arura Zeresh, Berucha Esther, after say, Aruchim Kol Beruchim, Kol Israel, Aruchim Kol Reshaim, sorry, and Beruchim Kol Israel, and you finish by Vegam Harbona. And say, Harbona, Gematria, Pinchas Eliyahu, Ima Kolel, Zachor Letov, Sam Dalfon. If you read all this,
On a l'épée, nous. Les pinchasim. On découpe les... Découpeur de Yesod.
Amalek
faisait
ça.
Amalek. Non, ça arrive bien. Tu commences à parler comme. comme Vashti.
Amalek faisait ça. Son grand-père.